gooseberries drive away anemia.
Hello, children. Did you recognize me? Haven't you? Okay, I will give you a few hints. As you are all seeing, I am slightly pale green in color. I am round in shape. People eat me in the form of a vegetable and a fruit. They make pickles out of me, and I am very useful. Can you guess who am I? I am available in all seasons, and you should necessarily eat me during rains. Haven't you recognized me yet? I am Amla. As I had earlier mentioned, you all should definitely eat me during rainy season. You all must be wondering why I should be eaten specifically during rainy season. To respond to this, I will take you all to a small village in West Bengal. Look, it's raining very heavily now, and children are enjoying the rains. The objective of this video is to understand some aspects of malaria and anemia.
Babu, it's so much fun playing with paper boats in the puddles during monsoon.
I'm also enjoying a lot. But Rimi, look there in that puddle. There is something black in there.
Babu, it's very slippery. Just be careful.
Rimi, look here. There are thread-like structures in this puddle. They look like small insects. God, there are so many.
Children, what are you doing here? Stay away from the puddle.
But why, Didi?
Look there at that puddle. Can you see some thread-like grey things swimming?
Yes, Didi, we saw them.
These are called larvae. These grow from the eggs and after a few days become mosquitoes.
Larva? What is it? First you said larva, now eggs. What does it mean?
Mosquitoes are first born in the form of eggs. Then they become larva and finally larva grows into mosquitoes. Although mosquito is a tiny insect, it is the cause for many diseases.
While we are on the topic of larva, can you make a list of insects that first are in the form of eggs and then turn into larva? Also, please write the life cycle of the insects.
Oh, all right. Mosquitoes appear to be very dangerous.
Yes, indeed. Mosquitoes are dangerous. Come, let us go back home. This weather is not good.
Didi, I shall also come with you. I'm curious to know as to why the mosquitoes are dangerous. Will you explain it to me?
Yes, Babu, I shall surely explain.
Didi, please explain everything about the various aspects of a mosquito. Our curiosity is increasing.
Although mosquitoes appear very small, they cause various diseases. Do you know, not all mosquitoes are dangerous?
Then, which are the mosquitoes that spread diseases?
Mosquitoes that carry disease-causing organisms bite humans, then malaria, chikungunya, and a few more diseases spread.
Our teacher was saying, Abir didn't come to class last week for a week as he had malaria. But what is malaria and what are its symptoms?
Malaria is caused by a parasite which resides in the body of a mosquito. So, when the disease-causing mosquito bites humans, they get malaria.
How does one come to know that an individual has malaria?
When a person has fever, chills, headache, nausea and weakness-like symptoms, doctor advises him to get himself tested for malaria.
What are these tests like?
When you go to the doctor with these symptoms, he will first suggest a blood test. A little blood is taken and tested.
Where does the blood get tested? How do they come to know it's malaria?
It gets tested in the lab under a microscope. If the blood contains malarial parasites, malaria is confirmed and the treatment is given.
While Didi and children are discussing about malaria, I wish to tell one thing. Do you know that Ronald Ross had played a major role in detecting malaria and he got the Nobel Prize in medicine? Ronald Ross did his research in India itself.
I am scared of this disease, but there must be ways this disease can be prevented.
Yes, there are ways. One should not allow water to get stored, as mosquitoes can breed in this. Always fill the puddles. Use mosquito net while sleeping. Keep the water tanks and pots dry when not in use. Spray kerosene if water has got collected.
But Didi, despite all these precautions, if we get malaria, is it dangerous?
No, not always. There are strong medicines to cure malaria and patients get all right. However, it is important to keep the surroundings clean. With this, we can control the breeding of mosquitoes to a large extent.
Children, we learnt about malaria, its symptoms, causes and their preventive measures. We need to keep in mind the instructions given by Didi.
Didi, as I had mentioned earlier, Abir keeps falling sick very frequently. I wonder what has gone wrong with him.
Maybe he is suffering from anemia?
What would happen if a person suffers from anemia?
Anemia occurs due to lack of blood.
Oh.
Due to anemia, there is lack of blood in our body and we feel weak. Due to this condition, one falls sick very frequently and there is a loss of immunity.
Didi, can you give us more clarity?
Usually, patients suffering from malaria have anemia. Also, people who have no malaria also suffer with anemia. In this condition, hemoglobin levels are low.
What is hemoglobin? It sounds scary.
No, it is not scary. Hemoglobin is a component of blood which carries oxygen from blood to different parts of the body. There should be a certain level of hemoglobin in everyone's blood. It differs for children, men and women. If that level is less, it causes anemia.
Children, hemoglobin is one component of blood. Can you find out the other components of blood?
Didi, how can anemia be prevented? What should be done?
To prevent anemia, we should eat a lot of green leafy vegetables, gooseberry, jaggery, which contain iron. Due to the presence of iron, they help in maintaining good hemoglobin levels.
Have you heard? My name is being called out. I am so beneficial.
What is iron?
Iron is an important component of hemoglobin. Due to the presence of iron, the body will have good energy levels and adequate quantities of hemoglobin. One does not fall sick if adequate iron levels are there. It is found in spinach, soybean, apples, etc.
Didi, as you had earlier mentioned that malaria has certain symptoms, does anemia also have symptoms?
Yes, due to anemia, there is tiredness and weakness in the body. Apart from this, humans experience breathlessness, dizziness, swelling of tongue and paleness of the skin. It is therefore essential to eat the mentioned foods in good quantities. This keeps the body healthy.
Didi, you have given such good information. Let me go and share this with my parents.
Yes, both of us will go to school tomorrow and we will talk to everyone about malaria and anemia, their symptoms and ways to prevent them. Through this, we can spread awareness among people.
Children, hope you all got sufficient knowledge about malaria and anemia, their symptoms, reasons, and ways to prevent them. In this video, we have discussed about the food items that need to be consumed in order to prevent anemia and to maintain the required quantity of hemoglobin. Health is wealth, and it is very important to protect it. Thank you.